Hello, my name is Eric and my project is on using G-Quadruplex-Mediated inhibition of alternative lengthening of telomeres as a means of curing cancer. Don't worry if this doesn't make sense right now, I'll explain what these are later. So the ends of chromosomes have repeated DNA sequences called telomere DNA. Every time a cell divides, the telomere DNA shortens a little bit and this causes aging. Eventually, the telomeres get too short and the population stop dividing. This is what happens in normal cells. It would be nice if we could live forever, but we live in an imperfect world where there's things like getting old, taxes, and cancer. Speaking about cancer, this is what goes on in a cancer cell. Cancer cells use an enzyme called telomerase to extend their telomeres and become immortal. So a really cutting-edge approach to curing cancer is to inhibit telomerase, since telomerase expression is conserved across all cancers. This has worked pretty well, but there are two problems. First, telomerase inhibition is slow, because you have to wait for the cancer cells to shorten their telomeres. Second, 15% of cancers don't even need telomerase to survive. Instead, they use a process called alternative lengthening of telomeres, or ALT, which involves homologous recombination. Now, as it turns out, there are these really neat structures that form from telomeres called G-quadruplexes. G-quadruplexes are highly polymorphic and super stable, and they prevent both telomerase and ALT from lengthening the telomere. So for my project, I wanted to examine the effects of recombination ability in ALT cells in presence of G-quadruplex ligands that force the telomere into G-quadruplex DNA formation. For my project, I used different kinds of yeast cells to simulate telomerase cancers and ALT cancers. I treated these cell lines with G-quadruplex ligands and let them divide. I also harvested their DNA every 20 divisions for a total of 6 measurements. Then I used qPCR to measure the amount of subtelomere amplification in the ALT cells. I also did some growth curve testing with a spectrophotometer to verify short-term growth effects of the drugs. I discovered that the ALT yeast cells with missing telomeres did die earlier than the wild-type in senescent controls. Also, growth curves show that this strain of cells grew the slowest in the presence of ligands. Even though they did die earlier, these cells still experienced 10 to 100-fold recombination. Interestingly, no growth effect was observed in ALT cells with inactive telomerase only. So in conclusion, my project presents a new way to circumvent alternative lengthening of telomeres in cancer without affecting normal senescing cells, and that telomeres might have a protective function in addition to telomere lengthening.